And Stitcher starts the break, and Hanson got hit at center ice. Back the other way, and another player down as the puck goes into the net. Yannick Hanson goes after Nazem Kadri. Daniel Sedin is hurt.
Right on the heels of the hit in the neutral zone by Riley.
Riley on Hanson in the neutral zone. Kadri on Daniel Sedin, who's still trying to get up. And in the midst of all that, the puck went into the back of the net.
I don't even know if anybody's noticed that fact. You be the judge here. Through the middle of the ice, puck's gone. But that was more body on body. And Hanson just fell. But right here, you can see the reaction immediately. Daniel Sedin's shot goes through, and no hesitation whatsoever by Yannick Hanson coming right in, and he goes right after Kadri. Shot went top shelf off the stick of Zaitsev. So a huge goal and a big momentum swing here, but it'll be tough to figure out what to call.
And on the drop of the puck, there's going to be a scrap. Derek Dorsett and Leo Komarov. One's an irritant, one's more of a scrapper. And you can tell which one is used to being in fights.
Well, you know, the guy on the bench for the Leafs right now is the other number 15, who's probably saying, well, why didn't you do that when you had your chance with me? Komarov, as you mentioned, is... And there's the talk at the bench as Martin...
Oh, he better be careful here.
Get yourself back in there. You knew that was coming, though, with the fact that he wouldn't fight Martin, and now... Cooler heads prevail. That would be a big mistake for Martin to jump on.
And a big mistake to manhandle a linesman.
And it was definitely Dorsett who's dropped his gloves first on that play right off the faceoff. So interesting what the call will be here.
Turned into a pretty nasty. So this is the hit on Yannick Hanson by Morgan Riley. And Hanson was okay because he quickly got up, and after the next hit, went after Nazem Kadri. But there's, it looked like a stick, bit of a spear to Morgan Riley.
Yeah,
and it hurt him.
Clearly in pain, but not so now. So he's back in the game and not looking any worse for wear.
He's on the ice, and so is Alex Burrows, and that's who Riley's talking to. Vancouver kid and a Vancouver Canuck.
More jawing going on the ice too.
And Burrows is coming right after him. Hacking, whacking, and here you go.
And Riley wrestles into the ice. And they really don't get much of a chance to scrap. On the drop of the puck, after much discussion before the puck was dropped, Burrows went right after Morgan Riley, and the referees have more to sort out. Ben Smith off the glass and up. Foot race, Matt Martin got ahead of Troy Stetcher, passed the puck to Soshnikov, and he couldn't control it. Sven Berchi is back. Oh, here we go again. This is Troy Stetcher and Matt Martin. In comes Ryan Miller to help out the rookie defenseman. It was up against Matt Martin, and now we get a line brawl. All the way down the ice is Frederick Anderson to join in this as well.
Yeah, for Matt Martin, he's not happy that Dorsett went after Komarov, but of all guys to go in against Stetcher in his fourth game in the National Hockey League. And the reaction was immediate by Ryan Miller. He just jumped out of his crease.
Tonight we turn the clocks back an hour, and these teams have turned the league back 30 years.
At the end of the day, the goaltenders, what are you doing down here? I'm just helping out my teammate. I don't blame Miller there, as you see coming to Stetcher's defense. And that's, I'm sure, what the conversation is there.
So we break this up. Matt Martin talking to the Vancouver bench. They're all standing as he goes by and heads for the dressing room. A lot lots more to sort out for these referees. And here's a look at it. Ryan Miller saw Stetcher was in trouble, jumped in against Matt Martin, and a line brawl ensued on Hart.